Portable stud welding is easy to operate and can be used to install many types of fasteners, including things like weld pins, weld studs, and Cuphead or mini cup insulation pins. At Midwest Fasteners, we know that getting work done fast and with reliability is really important to most jobs, and we have ways to help with that. The fast and practical application of capacitor discharge stud welding, a process often called CD welding for short. Installing fasteners with CD welding can be very portable and uses everyday 110 volt power. In addition to ease of use, CD welding systems have simple parts, work quickly, and can be used on thin metals to apply a range of fasteners. The process of capacitor discharge welding occurs in a series of four rapid steps: contact, ignition, placement of the fastener, and completion of the weld. Looking at a standard Midwest portable CD welder, here are the components of the weld system. A power unit, which is plugged into the source for 110 volt power. A CD gun with cables, a ground cable and clamping connection, and finally, gun accessories to fit the fastener to the gun. These parts make up the CD system, and we are ready to install parts using CD stud welding. With the gun prepared for the fastener to be welded, the fastener is held in the gun and everything is properly adjusted. The fastener makes contact with the surface to be welded as the operator locates the weld gun flat to the surface. Pressure is applied and the CD gun is triggered. And just that quickly, the CD equipment completes the weld. The welded part shows no backside distortion or burn through, and the weld will provide good strength under pressure. The strength of the CD weld is strong enough to fail in the fastener before it fails in the weld when properly applied, ultimately giving us superior strength for holding firmly in place on many types of applications and uses. Since the CD process can deliver 15 to 20 welds per minute, material is installed quickly and positively. 110 volt systems can weld as quickly as you load, contact, and weld. Using the same type setup and steps, we can also apply stud-sized fasteners just as quickly and reliably. Testing again shows the strength of the CD weld, which is strong enough to fail in the fastener before it fails in the weld. On very light gauge materials, the base of the stud will actually pull out of the material, maintaining the weld under stress rather than show failure in the fastener. In this case, the weld is maintained, but base material is not sufficient to support the load. Therefore, the base metal shows the failure, but the CD stud weld still holds. Improperly welded parts can be read to evaluate problems with application. As we saw earlier, a properly welded CD part will fail in the fastener before failing in the weld. That weld also illustrates proper burn-in and weld appearance. Notice the weld has 360 degrees of melted material at the base. This melding is consistent, tends to adhere to the base diameter of the stud, and is not splashing out away from the stud base. A cold weld looks different and will fail because of too little heat or too little time in the weld cycle. Notice in this sample of a cold weld that there is little or no melted material around the base of the welded stud. Also, the stud or pin can appear to be sitting up on the material and not illustrate good bonding into the base metal after the weld cycle. Looking at the failed part, we see a silver, soldery appearance and sometimes even remains of the weld tip, which was not fully ignited. In this case, heat or time needs to be adjusted to work together. We see this most often at Midwest Fasteners when proper accessories are not used, or when the accessories are not used properly in the setup of the weld gun. Hot capacitor discharge welds are also easy to spot. With too much heat or too little weld time, there is a noticeable splash of the weld material away from the stud base. In some cases, there is so much splash that there is just not enough metal to weld to as the stud weld is made. A failed hot part like this also shows a violent burnout during the weld cycle, giving it the name hot weld. Again, heat or time needs to be adjusted to work together. The technical support group at Midwest Fasteners tells us that we see this problem most often when proper accessories are not used or not used properly. This occurs in the CD weld gun setup and especially when the CD welder is turned up too high in its voltage setting to solve weld quality problems. Be sure to consult your owner's manual or equipment markings for proper settings for the diameter and type of part to be welded. Cuphead or mini cup welding is quite different due to the pin welding process for installations of this type. The welded cuphead is designed to provide support or pull-away strength sufficient to hold material in place. To test this, pull from under the washer head of the welded cuphead. Pulling straight away from the base tests the weld strength. Properly welded cuphead should withstand this test and feel strong in the bond to the base material. Cupheads are not designed to provide anything more than support strength and will not ordinarily show side-to-side or shear strength. For more on cuphead welding and how to install and test cupheads, see Midwest Fasteners video, How to Install Cupheads. For more information on weld studs and CD stud welding, please visit our industry-leading website at MidwestFasteners.com.